Well, in actual fact, if you want me to be funny, I bit my own head off. But in actual fact, some guy went at one gig on the last tour, threw a bat on stage, and every night we do a gig, you get all these crazy people that come and throw this junk on stage, and, you know. And I thought it was one of these rubber bats. I picked it up, and it was a real bat. You
know. Was it alive?
Well, it was till I bit the head off it, you know.
Yes. The next thing we want to get
you
out of the way...
You can't say anything about that now, can you?
Well, I could... Sure, you can say anything you want.
I mean, the taste of bats is very salty. It tastes like salt.
Tastes like anything else?
Well, yes, but I can't really say that on the air, can I, really?
No. Next, we want to see your tattoos, because we've heard you have the most incredible tattoos. Can you show them to us?
I have a piece of art here.
Oh, that's beautiful.
It's great, don't you think? Tattooed by the bat.
And do you have any others?
Many more. I'm covered in them.
Wait, so let's see that one again.
That's my mother-in-law.
Ozzy, your reputation is that of a wild man. We want to know how that started.
If I can try and explain this situation
Please.
In one... I don't know. It's like, I think there's a wild man in everybody, you know. It's like, all I am is a conductor of mayhem. I like to see people get off in a good way. I like to give myself to people as Ozzy. Ozzy is a very, sometimes very unhappy person because of one side of it, my life, it's like constant work and the understanding that people know me and like what I do. A lot of people do. I'm very privileged in that respect. But there's a side of me that wants to say, hey, you know, I want to go fishing in the lake, you know, I want to go whatever I want to do, you know, I want to do everything what everybody else does. But because of what I am, because of who I am, I said to you earlier on before we came on the air, I'm a split personality. Ozzy Osbourne and John Osbourne is two different people. John Osbourne is talking to you now, but if you want to be Ozzy Osbourne, you know, it's like, takes over, you know. It kind of, to be Ozzy 24 hours a day is kind of heavy, you know. It's like, people expect you to like bite the heads off things every time, every day they see you. They pull phrases at you when they recognize you in the street. And it ain't kind of fun, you know, because like me and my wife, Sharon go out to dinner sometimes and people recognize us in the restaurant there. I go, what's he eating, that duck? He probably bit the head off it, you know? And it's kind of, so what, you know? I mean, do you know why I do what I do? The reason why I do what I do is because it's what everybody wants to do, but they ain't got the guts to. And all I am is honest. I mean, okay, take it for instance. They're putting, every gig I do, I get put down for biting the head of this and all this and cruelty to animals. I don't do all that junk. I nearly said shit then, but I don't do all that. I don't do it, but people elaborate on Ozzy Osbourne. People are my best publicists because they phone the next gig and they say, Ozzy, come in, he blew the head off five sheep and cut the ankles off five cows and whatever, you know. It's like, people elaborate, and Ozzy Osbourne has been created through them, not through me. All I did was go out there and make a mistake of biting the head off a bat. And I tell you what, guys, it ain't fun when you get them rabies shots. Them shots hurt, man. You know, it's like heavy duty, man. It's like I had 24 shots of rabies vaccine, and it's not fun.
You're not going to bite any more bats?
Oh, yeah.
Oh. Are you protected now from
yeah.
the rabies shots?
My wife bit me this morning. I'm still...
Are you calling your wife a bad Ozzy?
No, she's beautiful. My wife is the best. My wife, Shazzy's the best. I love her to death.
That's nice to hear. You said that you have a split personality.
I have
the wild Ozzy Osbourne and the John Osbourne who likes to go fishing. How do you psych yourself up to be Ozzy, and how do you unwind to be John?
With great difficulty, actually. I mean, it's kind of difficult for me to sit here and answer these questions when I'm in myself, you know. It's kind of like saying, people say, hey man, it's Ozzy. You know, it's like, you gotta go instantly, you gotta go, I'm Ozzy, man. It's like, I'm happening, you know. I'm on. I'll never turn these guys down. They can come, and they can come. But all I say to myself is, surely to God, they respect me as a person as well as an artist, you know.
You've had some tough times, Ozzy. You were open enough to talk about it, and I think our fans would love to hear your comeback, as it were, from the road of what you talked about, drugs and booze.
I took a lot of drugs. I still drink booze. Not to the point, I mean, I have the ability to say enough, whereas a lot of these poor, unfortunate people say no. I took drugs like it was going out of fashion. But you know, one day I said to myself, hey man, that's a false existence, you know. Taking dope is a doper's attitude. It's like a freak. I'm not a freak. I've got a talent, a God-given talent, you know, to give to people. What do I want to spoil it for by taking drugs? Drugs is for fools, man.
And but, so you were able to get off them?
Sure, I mean, it's like, it's whatever you want to do. If you want to go, it's like, I mean, I had a drink problem at one time. I was drinking tons of alcohol every day. I went to a doctor, and the doctor said to me, he said, hey, man, how bad do you want to get off the drink? I just stopped and I said to myself, I don't know, you know? Until you say to yourself, I want to kick it, you know? That's the only time you'll kick it.
Who do you think has influenced your stage shows the most?
Me.
Where did you get your ideas from? From working in a mortuary when you were 15?
Adolf Hitler.
What do you mean by that, Ozzy?
Adolf Hitler had a charisma in a bad way. And I kind of admired him. He was a freak, he was a lunatic. But he had something about him, you know. I know it was all bad what he did. It was terrible what that guy did. He killed all these people and whatever. But it was like, he had something about him, you know. And I admired him, not for what he was, but for people. And I suddenly stopped to myself, hey man, if somebody put that in the positive way, for the good of mankind, and that's all I mean, whatever anybody says about me, I may be the biggest lunatic that you've ever met in your life, guys, but I'm here for your guys, for you guys. I'm here for people. I'm here for enjoyment. I'm here for giving people my life, my soul, my everything.
Would that be the one message that you would want your fans to come away with?
I mean, it's like, life is an experience. I don't know. I mean, people often ask me these questions, and I don't know. I really don't know how to answer these questions because I'm here. It's happening to me. I mean, people ask me a question, I say the answer. But is it the right answer? Because I don't know, you know. I mean, it's like, I'm here doing a gig. I'm doing a job. If I was sweeping the roads, that would be my gig. I would be doing my gig, you know. But I'm here. I'm fortunate. I'm very lucky. I don't let it take over me. I try not to let it take over me, although sometimes it does, because I think my best defense, I'm not a fighter. My best defense is my ego, because I say, I don't need you, man. I can walk to the bank any day of the week, you know. And that's the only time I ever use my ego. I hate the word ego. I hate the whole deal of ego. I hate the whole thing about this business. Is the fact is that I am here. I am still fortunate enough that people are still wanting to hear my music. And that's a God-given gift which no one can take away from me apart from a shotgun or something, you know, or a die or something.
Because right now the record industry is down, it's hurting. Even with that, you sell like crazy. Can you account for that, or how can you account
for
that?
I don't know, you know, it's like you walk down the road, you think, the way it happens, I don't play an instrument. I don't play an instrument, I don't know what key I'm singing, I don't know what anything. I just have this ability to be fortunate to be in this right situation at the right time for something to happen to me. From the beginning, that was. Now I walk down, it's like I think, bubble gum, boo-boo. You know, and it's like it comes out my head, you know. I don't know where it comes from. I mean, people say, hey man, you're the Prince of Darkness and you worship Christ and the devil backwards and all this. I don't even think about it. I just get on with it, you know. But you know, in the United States of America, for instance, when you suddenly become a success, there are a minority of the people that suddenly start to think, hey, this guy has got to be singing backwards. So they play the record backwards. And they say, what? And they say to me, I'm into Scientology, man. Do you know what your record sounds like backwards? I go, no, it probably sounds like... You know, and that's what they want to do, you know. I don't understand these freaks. They're all bananas, you know. Why don't people say, hey, I like the tune, man. I'll stamp my foot and get off on it, you know.
If you weren't a rock and roll star, what would you be?
A burglar.
What would you burglarize?
Ladies' underpants.
What kind of music do you listen to when you're home?
Silence.
No music, no favorite artists, no albums?
Because I find that if I listen to music, I find that it has an influence on what I'm going to write, you know. I write totally out of my head.
Will your stage shows continue to get wilder, or have they gone as far as they can go?
No, I'm going to get an atom bomb in the next show, you know.
You're going to do what?
An atom bomb. An atomic nuclear device.
Oh, and you're going to explode that in your next show?
Nah.
Aside from recording and performing, what do you like doing best?
Sex.
What other hobbies do you have?
Sex.
Okay. Why did you shave your head, Ozzy?
I was kind of bored, you know. I thought, well, what can I do today, you know? I was bored of saying to the traffic warden, hey, don't book me. You know, shave me. No, I just thought, seriously, I thought, shave your head. And do you know what?
No. What?
I guess you didn't know. Last night at the gig, there's a lot of kids in the audience with shaved heads. Look what I'm doing to the United States of America, man. I'm a public threat.
You're putting all the barbers out of business. What?
What do you mean putting them out of business? I'm giving them trade, man. I'm getting concessions. All the barbers in New York are getting money off me, man. All these long-haired guys are going here, cut my hair, I want to look like Ozzy, man. Hit me with a hammer.
Are you planning to do any videos?
Videos? It all depends, darling.
You know, you've been quoted as saying that you have become infatuated with the feeling of horror and with life's phobias. Can
Listen,
you...
My answer to that question is, have you ever heard of a guy called Vincent Price?
Yes.
Vincent Price acted a role in many, many horror movies. Has anyone ever stopped to think what he lives like? Does he live in a castle with bats and vampires? It's a role I play. I give the kids what they want, and I am what they want to be. I am what they want me to be.
What do you think the kids want?
Sensationalism. I think they want an escape. Because let's face it, you know, I mean, I was a kid once. I'm in my 30s now, and I was a kid once, you know, when I first started, for instance, with Black Sabbath, I suddenly decided, I thought, there's all this crap going on about boy meets girl, girl meets boy, and they all break up, and they all make it love, and all this, and flowers, and roses, and whatever. I thought, this is not real, you know. Whatever I write with a bit of what I feel, you know. How can I say to you, good morning. People, you know, this country, it gets me. Have a nice day. That's a load of horse, whatever.
Well, what would you rather say? Does anyone have a lousy day?
No, you say to people, how are you feeling? Crap. If you feel miserable, you feel miserable, you know? Good morning. What's good about it, you know? My old man just run off with a maid, you know? What's good about this? I'm just kind of good to see you, man. It's all a lot of junk, you know. People today in this society live in such a false existence. And all I try to do is bring them to reality. And the way I do it is by ramming a bit of truth down. You know, Crazy Train was about, I thought at one point in my life, I'm going off the rails on a crazy train. The whole world's a crazy train, you know. Everybody's building so many devices to destroy us all. What about the goodness of it all? What about saving us all, you know? What about building the bridge across the river instead of blowing the bridge up that was half built before they crossed the river, you know?
If the truth be told, Ozzy Osbourne, is it really that you're sane and the world is crazy?
No. I'm insane. Everybody else is too. I'll tell you, there's a house. I mean, if I'm right, I know where there's a house for.
Where?
Lunatic Asylum, man. It's a great place to be. There's no business. It's like showbiz.
On that up note, all we can say is thank you for being here. It's been an experience.
It's been great to be here. It's been gorgeous.
Thanks.
God bless you.
Night Flight's newest feature, The Comic, is coming up next.